Hi, everybody, and welcome. This is Dawn at nerdygirlcreative.com, which is a site created by yours truly. It's a place where you can create, learn, and share graphic design and web design ideas and projects. Today, I wanted to do something a little fun and a lot nerdy. Like a lot of people, I have become obsessed with the Netflix TV series Stranger Things. I just finished binge-watching all of the episodes, and now I am in love. I loved everything about it. The characters, the story, and especially the throwback to the 80s. In particular, I fell in love with the title sequence. So today, I wanted to show everybody how to recreate the text effect style in Photoshop. So let's get started. We're gonna create a new document. So we're gonna go to File, New, and then we're going to set our width at 1200 pixels, our height at 700, and we're going to leave our color mode at RGB. All right. So the two fonts that we're using in the title sequence are Benguat. I have no idea if I pronounced that correctly. It's spelled Benguiat, and Avant-Garde Gothic. These are not free fonts, at least as far as I could find, but I do have a couple links that I'll leave in the description below where you can find these fonts. Somewhere along the line, I picked up the first font, and so I was super excited when I found that in my little library. But I did not have the second font, so I just kind of came up with an equivalent, which is Text Gear Aventure Bold. All right, in the first font, we're going to go ahead and create three separate text layers. Our first layer is going to be 200 pixels large. We're going to create the S. Everything is going to be in caps. Oops, I'm sorry. Let's switch it so you can see it. All right, so there's the S. Then we're going to go to the R, same size. And our next set of characters, we're going to set at 120 pixels. All right, so we're going to do the leftover TRANGE. All right. So now I'm going to hit B on my keyboard, and I'm going to go ahead and start positioning everything center. Okay, so right now I actually have the TRANGE. I have my kerning, which is the width between the font characters, already set to where I need to, but I'll show you how to set that. So you're going to go to your character panel. If you don't see it over here, you can go up to Window and hit Character, and it'll pop out for you. So I'm going to go ahead and go to Character. This right here is where you're going to see the width between the words. We're going to set it at negative 50. As you can see, it's normally set at 0. See how much wider that got? The title is very close together, so we're going to go ahead and set it at negative 50. I'm going to go ahead and push my R in with my keypad. Just tap it in a little bit just so it gets a bit closer. The S is maybe one tap over. All right, so now we're going to start creating some of the magic. All right, so we're going to come down here to our effects panel, click open, go ahead and hit stroke. As you can see, I already have it set how I want, but we're going to set the size to 3 pixels. The position is going to be on the outside. The blend mode is normal, opacity at 100%. And the red pop red color that we're using here, a nice bright red, is FC0808. All right. Then we're going to go ahead and apply that to all the others. Stroke. Already. And there we go. All right. So the next thing we're actually going to do is I'm going to bring the S back out just a touch. Once you get that outside outline, it becomes a little bit tight. The R2, I'm going to bring it back out just a couple of times. There we go. All right. They also have rectangles on the upper and lower levels. So we're going to go ahead and create our rectangle, just sort of stretch it across. We're also going to do the same effect that we have on the text. So go down, stroke, hit okay. And I'm just going to go ahead and duplicate this layer. I'm going to bring it down. And I'm going to Command T or Control T on a Windows. And I'm just going to shorten this up. Okay. Right about there. Then I'm going to tap it up. And I'm going to go ahead and copy this one. Duplicate there. Move this one straight over. Now, as you can see, the S kind of comes down a bit further than the R does. I'm actually just going to Control T the R and just bring it down just a tad, just so it matches up a little bit better. And then I'm going to free transform and bring this in just a tiny bit. Same with the other rectangle. All right, it's starting to look good. All right, so now we're going to go create a rectangle. Actually, I'm just going to move this down here. We're going to create one the size of our canvas to give us our nice black background. And we're going to bring it down below all of our text. That way we can actually see. Now you can see where it pops, really stands out. All right. I'm actually going to down just a bit. Okay, so here is where the fun stuff happens. Oh, sorry, my dogs. All right, so we're gonna double click on our effects section right here. You can also go down here and click on the effects here. So double click. We're gonna give it an outer glow. Okay, so I already have the set. So the opacity is 28%, zero noise. We're gonna have it at hard light on our blending mode. This color is going to be the same color that we were using before. The spread, 3%, size, 18 pixels. Everything else is pretty much default. So you'll just hit OK. And then we're going to do the same for the rest. Just give them all outer glows. They should all be set already. And as you can see, now they really kind of pop from that back, the dark black background. I'm actually going to just resize this just a tiny bit. There we go. We're going to do the same on the triangle or on the rectangles. All right, now we got the nice, good 80s strange kind of glow going on. I'm going to tap down the top rectangle just a bit. Scooch it in. All right, so now we're going to create another layer. We're going to go over here to our brush panel. We're going to go ahead and select a brush. Click up here. You're going to want one that's set at zero hardness, a very soft brush. The size, you don't really need to worry about it at the moment because we're going to be resizing it anyway. So we're going to go ahead and close that. All right, so here's where we get all the nice highlights that we can add. All right, so I'm just going to go ahead and I have it set at black, sorry. I'm going to set it at white. And we're just going to start popping in some nice highlights here. We're going to enlarge the brush by hitting our closed bracket key. Can't really see it that well just because of the black background, but there we go, nice big one. I'm going to put a nice other big one here. I'm going to start making it smaller. Touch right there. Give a few. And one extra tiny highlight there. There we go. All right, so now we're going to set our color blend or the blending mode to overlay. And now it kind of just pushes it to the back and gives it that soft, nice glow. And you can tell the difference it makes, even though it doesn't seem very overwhelming, the difference. You can tell it when you toggle the layer on and off. You see how it kind of pops it up a little bit? And you can also, you know, add a little bit more in intensity. It's really up to you and what you think looks good. So I'm going to go over here and I'm going to go ahead and group things because it's always nice to keep everything nice and organized. And I'm just going to name it Stranger. Border. Highlights. All right. So now we're going to, if you don't notice, the actual title sequence is in both sets of these red numbers. The red letters, I'm sorry. But I did want to show you the other text font that's used in all of the other title parts, you know, the actors' names and everything like that. So I'm going to go ahead and find that down here. I have a lot. It's going to take me a second to scroll. Okay, so up here is where it is, and it is the bold. And I'm going to go ahead and type things. And like I said, it's not an exact match, but it's pretty close. All right. And with this one, the kerning doesn't need to be as close together, so I'm going to just push it back out, maybe to negative 25. I still like it scrunched, but it's pretty good where it is right now. All right, well, that's our tutorial on the Stranger Things text effect. I hope you guys like this new TV obsession-inspired tutorial. I know that I'm really excited and hope the next season doesn't take forever to come out. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe to these videos. I create a new freebie or tutorial every week, so if you have any suggestions for what you'd like to see me do next, leave me a comment below or go over to nerdygirlcreative.com and send me an email. And don't forget to check out my amazing products over there. I have watercolor textures while you're over there. And as always, I had a blast making this tutorial for everyone. I love sharing my knowledge with you guys, so go out there and create something amazing.